What is up, everybody? Welcome to Dapple Productions. My name is Hat. I am joined here by LM. We are about to start the tournament tonight, which is Triton Cup 51. LM, my boy, how are you doing in this wonderful evening?
I am doing fairly well. Got a really busy day today. Just finished doing some Squid Coliseum. A new thing that's been going on, and it's honestly really fun just being able to just queue up with a bunch of other comp players and just fighting. It's really solid, but we're going to be starting on Triton Cup here with, all right, who's in charge of picking the maps? Who did it? Who picked Scorch?
I don't know. I think it's a good map.
Are you on Mars? Are you on Mars?
Yes.
Bro, we're on Zones in Scorch Gorge. This is probably one of the worst map modes in existence.
It's like Kelpdom, which is actually kind of funny because you can somewhat flank.
It's like Kelpdom. You're saying that like it's a positive!
Well, you see, look, there is not a lot of flanking that's been going on in this game. So the amount of flanking you can do here for me is enough. Even if you can't really get to the enemy spawn, which that's gonna suck. But let's get it going, because we do see some interesting weapons coming out from both of these teams. Namely the Dualist Sculptures and the Spartana, which I think are always weapons I like to see as well. Same with Nox rocking that Jet Squad. See, Witches 2 is coming into the zone first. Whisper in the orange and Incognito in the blue. It looks like Whisper is pushing in a little bit faster than Incognito is, but it's a, they got the first plant, but they quickly got a refrag on that 3v3 scenario. But Whisper is really pushing in, doing some numbers on that zone, but they still weren't able to capture it. Incognito is doing hard work to prevent that option here. Benji going in, but getting flanked actually by two people, unfortunately getting surrounded. It does mean Whisper can capture the zone. Even if Incognito got that splat on Benji, but still a very decent start for both of the teams. Let's see if Incognito can recapture with this push.
Yeah, let's see if they're going to be able to do it. Something I would like to note is that C-Jet, one of the new weapons coming out in the fresh season, I feel like it can be compared to what we saw as Explo for the past two seasons. The Nishin had on splat zones, but C-Jet, of course, is going to have that more mobility, so you can run an Explo or a C-Jet for that option. But as I'm saying that, the zone is going back into neutral, and something that really sucks about this map mode is how long it takes to retake. It really sucks to retake this zone because you got to go all the way around. But two down on Whisper is going to be really good for Incognito, and they just got to get in there, and they got to get picks, but they're just not getting in there. They're just not taking that opportunity, and we're seeing a splash pop their crab on top mid, but they're going to be dropping, and they're fighting pretty much all the opponents alone. Going to be picked off, just the Machine and Dueling Sculptures alive, and they got to make something happen. Machine's going to pop that Booyah Bomb, and it's not really going to do much. Dueling Sculptures going to get a pick on that Wiper, and they're trying to make more done, but that Tri-Strike is just going to keep paint coming out from that Neo Splash. And we're getting to the last couple seconds here, but we might see Incognito be able to take it back. But there's so much pain, and they're free down. It is just the Charger left alive. It is not looking good as they just got a paint. 3-2-1, and that is it. Whisper had a very dominant first game. Incognito couldn't really get in there. And it's just really hard to retake this zone, I'm going to be honest.
Yeah, I definitely agree there, because of the sheer amount of size and the amount of extra ink that Whisper had over Incognito, making it very difficult. But also, like you said, whenever they had the opportunity to push in, they kind of held back way too much. Said that pushing in is going to be difficult. Maybe they wouldn't want to do it. I don't know. Maybe it was some miscommunication within the team of Incognito. But yeah, they weren't super hard on the pushing. But that can all change when we go to Mincemeat Metalworks, which is a bit of a more layered kind of map. Doesn't have that big hump in the zone. The zone is way smaller, way easier to overtake, because like you said, the zone being so big makes it such a chore to overtake. Even getting to neutral, honestly, at least from my experience, it just takes so long. I don't like it.
Yeah, honestly, I also think Mincemeat is a really, really bad... Mincemeat is just a bad map, period. Like, there's no mode on this map that's good. There's none.
Raymaker's really fun. Raymaker's really fun. Kind of gives back the Hammerhead bridge fight.
It can get something, but honestly, Mincemeat is just a really bad map, and Zones definitely shows that off. It's just very, very stolly. It's just gonna be a back and forth. Like, while Scorch Gorge, it's really hard to retake. Here, it's just gonna be nothing but retake. We'd be surprised to see some points get on the board, especially if they're gonna be pulling out crab tanks. But you know, one of the positives I will give this, they have a car. They have the car.
That's true.
Yeah, they have Carr. Yeah, I have the room on the pole.
Yeah. What do you think about that, actually? Because every time I think back to the first season launch and all the map adjustments, they just added poles everywhere. I thought it was so funny. It's like, oh, here's a pole. Does it work? No. It only ruins the spat links. That's all it does. It does nothing else. It just ruins spat links because chargers can shoot below it. Spat links can do stuff anything with it, which is the demise of the spat link. And because of that, we don't see a splatling here. We don't even see a backliner. Everyone decided to go frontline because that is the way to go. Two machines on Incognito, one machine on Whisper. Whisper has two splash schematics, so they're kind of switching each other out with the katana still on Whisper and the Tentat Explosion spill on Incognito. Crab Tank first for Whisper. Actually gets a decent amount of painting, but definitely a handful of points. But now it is Incognito starting to start pushing. And they captured the zone quite quickly, taking the lead here as well. And pushing in a little bit more with a little bit of bigger lead because they have one player spotted.
Mm-hmm. We see Whisper getting the zone back once again. But that splash is going to be just hugged in by that Booyah Bomb. And that's going to be a wipeout on Whisper as Incognito is going to take the zone here. It seems that they're going to be putting more options on those Booyah Bombs, which are going to be really easy to cap the zone back for their team. And they have the T-Tech too, which, in my opinion, T-Tech and Neo Splash, it's like, if you want to play more support, you play the Splash. If you want to be more aggressive, you play that T-Tech. And we see that's what that T-Tech might be trying to do here. But of course, they're going to be lobbing Tri-Strikes out to try to displace those Crab Tanks. There's a lot of HP specials, so the Tri-Strike is going to be able to do a lot here. And the zone is going to go back to Whisper, but two Booyah Bombs on the zone is going to take it back immediately for Incognito, getting a pick on the machine. Another machine going to go down. Wiper's going to go down. It's just the splash in the corner. It's a 1v3 and another wipeout on Whisper.
Yeah, Whisper is not looking too hot this game. Incognito really decided to switch it up compared to last game. It's like a turn of Incognito mode. It actually started showing themselves and going in. They're still pushing up to the spawn and got rid of their penalty, so they're starting to score for points again, or push for points again. Crab Tank is out for Whisper. The Miss Treasure is also out for Whisper, doing massive amount of turf, but not enough as the zone is still neutral. Somehow, it isn't going back and forth like you said it would. The zone is still in a very nice neutral state, and it isn't really being painted at all, as three people are down for Incognito. Whisper does retake it. Finally, they took a large amount of time for Whisper to retake it, and even if they're out of their penalty right now, it's going to be a bit before they start really pushing for the lead.
Yeah, no, it's going to be a little bit. Now it's a reverse situation here. The late wipeout on Incognito is not going to do him any good, but they do have some specials at the ready. Crab Tank and Booyah Bomb are going to be coming out from Incognito, trying to see what they can do for that zone. Going to be able to retake it and two down on Whisper once again. Tri-Strike and Booyah Bomb are going to be coming out. Benji here in the corner trying to paint for their Crab Tank. Has it at the ready and it's going to pop it right here, but there's so many players on them that this Crab Tank is just not going to do much. But they do get a little bit of a trade with an assist there as Machine is just trying to lob shot from down under, trying to use it really well here. And here comes a Booyah Bomb out from Nox onto that left truck. Going to displace the members of Incognito, but they still have a solid hold and they don't have any penalty anymore. Going to 23, but they got to paint this zone and they got to outpaint the machine and the Crab Tank, which they do, getting three more points. But in the end, Whisper is going to take it back and might be pushing back Incognito. Going to be getting two down and trying to push up just a little bit more. Just a splash left alive. Can they find them? But they're getting jumps, another pick, and it's just that machine left alive. And this is looking really good for Whisper right now.
Yeah, Whisper definitely turned his way around now, but they have to hold it. That's going to be a difficult part. Booyah Bomb coming out from Nox, actually in a very decent position, but they get spotted along the way, and it doesn't look all too hot. The hammer now goes down onto EPI, who's holding the Booyah Bomb, but the hammer actually gets spotted and doesn't make a single spot. Booyah Bomb went out on the zone, though, but only neutralized it, as Whisper is still in control of that zone. They are so close to getting the Crab Tank is out for Incognito, but also getting spotted by Nox. Nox going in, looking at the Tentat Explosion and the other machine. Getting some help for the teammates to get those splats in. Unfortunately, Incognito recaptured for a small, brief second. I didn't quite see how long it was. They put a big penalty onto Whisper. That's going to be stinging for them because they have around a minute left to get in the lead. They are only at 13 ticks left for that penalty, so it can get down quite easily. And they're still in good control with two players down. It's going to be difficult for them to start holding onto it. And like that, the zone again captured by Incognito, putting an even bigger penalty on Whisper this time.
Mm-hmm. Seeing the Trishai now coming out on that live truck, trying to make sure there's no members of Whisper down there, but Yona is able to stay alive with that Splatana wiper, but they're going to get picked off, and another wipeout coming out on Whisper. Whisper just can't seem to find their footing for even for long, as it's almost done with penalty for Incognito here, getting another pick on another splash and just trying to stall them out in their spawn here. Booyah Bomb will be coming out. Another splash is going to go down. They're going to use the Booyah Bomb right there. But we're about to get into single digits here. Only two left alive on Whisper. There's so many down. And that is it. Incognito is going to take that second game. And now we're going to be going to the third match.
A very good game indeed from Incognito. Really switched around. Whisper had some great pushes, but overall Incognito showed so much more strength. The crazy amount of wipeouts we saw Incognito getting on Whisper. Honestly, Whisper not really doing the cooperative team effort like they did in Scorch. I'm actually wondering who's going to win the next map in Mahi.
Yeah, but now we're going from some of the more worse off Splat Zones maps to probably one of the better Splat Zones maps. In my opinion, I think this is one of the best Splat Zones maps. If you want to play Splat Zones, you might want to play Mahi.
Oh, 100% Mahi is a lot of fun. Even though I think, compared to Splatoon 1, they absolutely ruined it. It is insane.
Oh, yeah.
They hurt my boy so much. I don't think it's a super bad map per se, but it definitely removed a lot of the more interesting elements that the map had out of it. But I think it's still like a 7. It's not bad per se. It's just not that crazy good. But I'm actually wondering what the kind of composition these teams will be running, because we saw Incognito doing very well on the close range comps, but we also saw that Whisper didn't do as well when they were both running close range. But when Whisper was running long range on Incognito, they actually had a very dominant edge. I'm wondering if Incognito will be more short range with Whisper going longer range this time.
Yeah, we're just going to have to wait and see. But yeah, I don't even know what it is. Like Mahi, I feel like is not the best map. I feel like it's a bad map. But for some reason, Splat Zones is just so good. It carries it from an F tier to like a D tier.
Yeah, because I think like backliners have such a hard time, so you can actually like move around. And because the map is fairly short, like even shorter range weapons have an easier time fighting against stuff like Starshers and Crab Tanks, because there's just a lot of ways to go around, and also because it's just one big paintable area, you can actually paint yourself a flank route. Let's see what's gonna go. I do see a Jet Squelch coming out and a Splatana from Whisper, so they decided that the original comp was the best one to go with, and Incognito decided that their winning comp from Mincemeat Meatworks was the best way to go. So both of the teams are running what they've won one game with. Let's see which is the more competitive comp. Two players down, three players down for Whisper. An early game lead for Incognito in terms of numbers of splats. And it's going to help them take the zone actually to a fairly decent start, pushing it already into the low 80s. And it's not looking all too good for Whisper, who are sort of trying to regain their ground. They have specials ready, which they will use surely to push in. But one player is down for both of these teams, so let's see if Whisper can retake it here.
Yeah, we're going to have to wait and see what they're going to be able to do. Whisper is out of penalties, and 2 down Incognito is what they want to see. They might be able to push in considering their positioning. They're just trying to stall them out with as many bombs as possible here. So close to that lead right now, just keeping paint with the moves of Incognito. They do have a Crab Tank at the ready, but both teams have a Crab Tank at the ready, getting so many specials at the ready but not really using them yet. And here we go, here's where Mahi starts to become one of the best map modes in the game, because the water level just dropped, and this is such an expansive map now compared to what it was before. Even before, it's still a solid map before the water drops compared to the other modes, but now we are seeing Nox here with that jet getting a pick on Raz, trying to keep the zone alive, but they got a 40 point penalty, so they got to keep it going. Again, trying to use the Inkstorm and their main weapon to get some chip damage out.
Yeah, but the big map is a big flank opportunities and a big crab coming out there as well in a very sneaky spot on the right. Does do quite a bit of damage, but especially good at pushing people away. Incognito, with the help of their teammates, can get the push in and actually very much push Whisper in a little corner in their spawn. Boom coming out from EPI as well, pushing them back even further. The Splatana is going to push on the side of the map. The Jet Squelch is helping them. The Crab Tank far up on the top, kind of
bunker thingamajig at the side. Will it be enough though? Brain is out on that stone as well, but I don't think the rain is going to neutralize it. And it with a splat in the middle, and hopefully it's enough for Whisper to capture it. The Booyah Bomb from Incognito prevents that from happening and still pushes Incognito forward, who just taken the lead. All Whisper had to kind of respawn or jump back to spawn, and it's going to be difficult for them because they don't have much time before Incognito really goes on. It creates a big gap here. Machine flanking on the right side. Artisan doesn't get a splat, but distracts enough to score a little more points. Yona with a hammer doesn't get a splat as well. Can the Patana get a splat though? No, they cannot. The zone is neutralized, and it is rain everything on its own. It's still so neutralized. The crap tank is on it as well. They finally captured it. I'm gonna recap this. They did capture it, but they got wiped out. It was like, wow, I had a second to take it in. That was crazy.
Yeah, that is honestly insane. But now they have a little more time to get back in there, but they gotta make a plan here. Using that crab tank, but the wiper is already down. Both the crab tanks are about to expire. They gotta get that zone, but they're gonna be made a little back. A wall making put by the tri-strike here, as Yona is trying to go on the aggression. Same with Axel, they gotta do something here. Trying to paint the zone. Two of them are down. Three of them are down. It's just a splash left alive, and that is another wipeout. They have barely any time to get back in there, but Nox is going to try their best getting a trade, but there's such little time. They gotta get something. They're just going for the zone. They're just feeding into the zone, and 3-2-1, game, set, and match with Incognito coming in and taking the set.
Absolutely crazy. Absolutely crazy that Incognito, what they did this game compared to when they started, to where they are now, just these three games alone, that's some serious short-term improvement, because wow, they really showed Whisper where they think they belong. I will say that those wipeouts, those are crazy. Like that one wipeout where even if Whisper took the zone, Incognito just took it back instantly. That was honestly insane.
Yeah, no, that was really good, especially considering how this was a reverse sweep. They did struggle on Scorch, but then they found their footing with the comp they wanted to put, switching out those dual sweepers for that T-Tech and being able to get the reverse sweep on Whisper, and it's now going to be moving on. But with that being said, we are going to be taking a quick short break before round two, so make sure to don't go anywhere as we will be right back.
Splatoon Stronghold, a stronghold for competitive Splatoon, providing resources to long-timers and newcomers alike. If you're new to the competitive scene or still figuring out how to join, we have a getting started guide and plenty of other resources to help you in your journey. If you are a seasoned veteran, we still have plenty to offer. You can find and join tournaments as well as participate in our captain forum and find free agents and teams. Our mission is to make competitive Splatoon easily accessible to everyone. So what are you waiting for? Join the Splatoon Stronghold today!